Big Brother, 1984. Big Brother is a fictional character and symbol in George Orwell's novel 1984. He is ostensibly the leader of Oceania, a totalitarian state wherein the ruling party Ingsoc wields total power for its own sake over the inhabitants. In the society that Orwell describes, every citizen is under constant surveillance by the authorities, mainly by telescreens, with the exception of the Proles. The people are constantly reminded of this by the slogan "Big Brother is watching you," a maxim that is ubiquitously on display. In modern culture, the term Big Brother has entered the lexicon as a synonym for abuse of government power, particularly in respect to civil liberties, often specifically related to mass surveillance. In the essay section of his novel 1985, Anthony Burgess states that Orwell got the idea for the name of Big Brother from advertising billboards for educational correspondence courses from a company called Bennett's during World War II. The original posters showed J.M. Bennett himself, a kindly-looking old man offering guidance and support to would-be students with the phrase "Let me be attached." According to Burgess, after Bennett's death, his son took over the company and the posters were replaced with pictures of the son, who looked imposing and stern in contrast to his father's kindly demeanor, with the text "Let me be your big brother." Additional speculation from Douglas Kellner of the University of California, Los Angeles argued that Big Brother represents Joseph Stalin. Another theory is that the inspiration for Big Brother was Brendan Bracken, the Minister of Information until 1945. Orwell worked under Bracken on the BBC's Indian service. Bracken was customarily referred to by his employees by his initials, BB, the same initials as the character Big Brother. Orwell also resented the wartime censorship and need to manipulate information, which he felt came from the highest levels of the Minister of Information and from Bracken's office in particular. In the novel, it is never made clear whether Big Brother is or had been a real person, or is a fictional personification of the party, similar to Britannia and Uncle Sam. Big Brother is described as appearing on posters and telescreens as a man in his mid-40s. In party propaganda, Big Brother is presented as one of the founders of the party, along with Goldstein. At one point, Winston Smith, the protagonist of Orwell's novel, tries to remember in what year he had first heard mention of Big Brother. He thought it must have been at some time in the 60s, but it was impossible to be certain. In the party histories, Big Brother figured as the leader and guardian of the revolution since its very earliest days. His exploits had been gradually pushed backwards in time until already they extended into the fabulous world of the 40s and the 30s, when the capitalists in their strange cylindrical hats still rode through the streets of London. In the book The Theory and Practice of Oligarchical Collectivism, read by Winston Smith and purportedly written by Goldstein, Big Brother is referred to as infallible and all-powerful. No one has ever seen him, and there is a reasonable certainty that he will never die. He is simply the guise in which the party chooses to exhibit itself to the world, since the emotions of love, fear and reverence are more easily focused on an individual, if only a face on the hoardings and a voice in the telescreens, than an organization. When Winston Smith is later arrested, O'Brien repeats that Big Brother will never die. When Smith asks if Big Brother exists, O'Brien describes him as the embodiment of the party and says that he will exist as long as the party exists. When Winston asks, "Does Big Brother exist the same way I do?" meaning, "Is Big Brother an actual human being?" O'Brien replies, "You do not exist," meaning Tat Smith is now a non-person, an example of doublethink. A spontaneous ritual of devotion to Big Brother, VB, is illustrated at the end of the 2 minutes hate. Though Oceania's Ministry of Truth, Ministry of Plenty and Ministry of Peace each have names with meanings deliberately opposite to their real purpose, the Ministry of Love is perhaps the most straightforward, as rehabilitated thought criminals leave the ministry as loyal subjects who have been brainwashed into adoring, loving, Big Brother, hence its name. Like the Nazi salute, Ingsoc has its own salute to Big Brother, which consists of crossing one's arms above the head during 2 minutes hates and hate weeks, showing loyalty to Big Brother and the party. Note that it is only mentioned and shown in the movie adaptation of the novel. Since the publication of 1984, the phrase Big Brother has come into common use to describe any prying or overly controlling authority figure in attempts by government to increase surveillance. Big Brother and other Orwellian imagery are often referenced in the joke known as the Russian Reversal. The magazine book ranked Big Brother number 59 on its 100 best characters in fiction since 1900 list. Wizard magazine rated him the 75th greatest villain of all time. The worldwide reality television show Big Brother is based on the novel's concept of people being under constant surveillance. In 2000, After the United States version of the CBS program Big Brother premiered, the estate of George Orwell sued CBS and its production company Orwell Productions Incorporated in federal court in Chicago for copyright and trademark infringement. The case was Estate of Orwell v. CBS, OOC 5034, and Il. On the eve of trial, the case settled worldwide to the party's mutual satisfaction, but the amount that CBS paid to the Orwell estate was not disclosed. CBS had not asked the estate for permission. Under current laws, the novel will remain under copyright protection until 2020 in the European Union and until 2044 in the United States. The iconic image of Big Brother, played by David Graham, played a key role in Apple's 1984 television commercial introducing the Macintosh. The Orwell estate viewed the Apple commercial as a copyright infringement and sent a cease and desist letter to Apple and its advertising agency. The commercial was never televised again, though the date mentioned in the ad, 24th of January, was but 2 days later, making it unlikely that it would have been re-aired. Subsequent, now posthumous, ads featuring Steve Jobs, for a variety of products including audiobooks, have mimicked the format and appearance of that original ad campaign, with the appearance of Jobs nearly identical to that of Big Brother. In 2008, The Simpsons spoofed Apple's Big Brother commercial in an episode entitled My Pods and Boomsticks. The December 2002 issue of Gear magazine featured a story about technologies and trends that could violate personal privacy, moving society closer to a Big Brother state, and utilized a recreation of the movie poster from the film version of 1984. Computer company Microsoft patented in 2011 a product distribution system with a camera or capture device that monitors the viewers that consume the product, allowing the provider to take remedial action if the actual viewers do not match the distribution license. The system has been compared with 1984's telescreen surveillance system. A series of laws intended to implement the European Union Data Retention Directive in Romania were nicknamed the Big Brother laws by Romanian media and civil society, as they would have led to blanket storage of citizens' telecommunications data for 6 months. All of these laws were struck down as unconstitutional by the Constitutional Court of Romania, and the directive itself was ultimately invalidated by the Court of Justice of the European Union. In the 2010 game Bioshock 2, there is an enemy named the Big Sister. The phrase Big Sister is watching is a reference to the 1984 phrase Big Brother is watching. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.